Hello from Chem Help ASAP. We're going to talk about a specific type of R group, and it's called an alkyl group. Normally, when people talk about R groups, the most common type of R group is a situation in which you have an sp3 hybridized carbon coming out off of whatever molecule you're talking. And when you have an sp3 hybridized carbon attached, this is called an alkyl group. So alkyl group, that name comes from the molecule alkane. So we've learned a little bit about alkanes. These are simple hydrocarbons. And I have two drawn on the left. One is methane, one is ethane. Don't worry about those names, but that's what they are called. To get to an alkyl group from an alkane, what we do is we just chop off one of our hydrogens, and then what's left is no longer an alkane, but an alkyl. Alkyl implies it's attached to something else instead of alkane, which is the entire molecule. Sometimes, and I tend to do this, I'll draw a line and kind of put a squiggle there, meaning there's something else attached. This is not a methane. This is now methyl, or methyl, sometimes people will call it, but I'll say methyl. For ethane, it's the same. Let's take off one of the hydrogens, this carbon, and the second carbon. And again, I like to put a squiggle there to imply there's something else coming off of there. This is not an ethane, this is an ethyl. So this is how we talk about these types of, in the upper right, sp3 hybridized carbon R groups. These are alkyl groups. So let's see an example of a molecule that contains a methyl group. This molecule actually contains multiple methyl groups, but I'm going to highlight these. This carbon off of this nitrogen, that is a CH3 group. This is an example of an alkyl group. So this is a CH3. That is a methyl group. We could also say the same about this carbon over here. And if we really wanted to look at every methyl, well, we have methyls as these carbons too. But really commonly, these are our R groups. So you could also write this and say NRR and R equals CH3. That would be how we express that as an R group. Let's look at a molecule that has an ethyl group. This molecule actually has two ethyl groups. This is a molecule called ethyl ether. And the oxygen has two R groups on it. This is our ethyl group. And that is a CH3-CH2 group on that oxygen. So alkyl groups are very common R groups. Normally, when people write R, they are including alkyl groups within those possibilities of that wild card of that R group.